Hello students, good morning to all. I hope all of you are fit and fine. So today we are going to study about properties of whole numbers. That is the part 2 of chapter 2 of math. So let's start. So before starting, we'll see what we have studied in last class. In last class we have studied about whole numbers. What is whole number? And we studied how to add, subtract and divide the whole numbers with the help of number line. So here we will study about properties of whole numbers. So what is property? What you have studied about property, or what have you heard about property? Is the property land? What we have heard, that land is the property. So your father has land, your mother has land, or your grandfather has land, that is also going under property. Or you have heard that, what you have heard, you have your, in your home you have gold, that is also coming under property. Or you have any money. So, in the property, what you are considering? Land, gold and money. But do whole numbers have land, gold and money? They does not have. Land, gold and money? That is not the property here. What is the property here? The characters. Like dog. Consider dog and cat. Dog or cat are considered. Character consider karo. So dog is different from cat. How? Dog size is big, but cat size is small. And you can see and tell the difference between dog and cat. Tumhe dog aur cat ko dekhi tumko bhitar difference koi paro. How? They have so many characters. So those characters are known as their properties. Say character ko tumhe kaun kahibo? Property. So here whole number has some character, and that characters are used to understand the numbers better. So this is the property of whole number. Let's see number one property is closure property. What it is written? Whole numbers are closed under addition and also under multiplication. Closure property. Closed under addition and multiplication. So let's see this closure property. What it is given? 7 plus 8. You know addition. 7 plus 8 equal to how much? It is 15. Then 5 plus 5. How much? 10. 0 plus 15. How much? 15. What you are seeing here? What we are getting? When you are adding two whole number, the sum is also a whole number. 15 is also a whole number. 5 and 5, both are whole number. 10 is also a whole number. 0 is a whole number. 15 is a whole number. And 15 is also a whole number. So when you are adding two whole number, the sum is also a whole number. So this is the closure property. So sum of any two whole numbers is a whole number. That is, collection of whole numbers is closed under addition. So when you are adding any two whole numbers, you are getting a whole number. That is also a whole number. So this is the closure property of addition. So this property is known as closure property of or addition of whole numbers. So this is about addition of whole numbers. So when you are adding any two whole number, you are getting whole number. So let's see about multiplication. 7 into 8. 7 8 ja 56. I hope all of you have remembered the multiplication table. Samastanku table manathiyo. If you have forgotten, then again remember. So you need now. Revise karo
आउ थरे ताकु रिमेम्बर करो ओके 5 5 25 0 इंटू 15 इक्वल टू 0 सो लुक हियर 7 एंड 8 बोथ आर होल नंबर एंड व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग द प्रोडक्ट इज आल्सो इन होल नंबर 5 एंड 5 आर होल नंबर 25 इज आल्सो एन होल नंबर ए होल नंबर 0 एंड 15 आर होल नंबर 0 इज आल्सो एन सॉरी होल नंबर सो व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग व्हेन वी आर मल्टीप्लाइंग टू होल नंबर द प्रोडक्ट इज आल्सो ए होल नंबर सो द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू होल नंबर्स इज आल्सो फाउंड टू बी ए होल नंबर अगेन वी से दैट द सिस्टम ऑफ होल नंबर्स इज आल्सो क्लोज्ड अंडर मल्टीप्लीकेशन सो होल नंबर इज क्लोज्ड अंडर क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दैट इज क्लोज्ड अंडर एडिशन दैट इज आल्सो क्लोज्ड अंडर मल्टीप्लीकेशन सो दिस इज द क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी सो इन क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी व्हाट व्हेन वी आर एडिंग टू होल नंबर वी आर गेटिंग ए होल नंबर व्हेन वी आर मल्टीप्लाइंग टू होल नंबर वी आर गेटिंग आल्सो एन होल नंबर सो दिस इज अबाउट क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी ओके नेक्स्ट except addition and multiplication we have another two operation that is what subtraction and division so let's see are they coming under closure property let's see are the whole numbers closed under subtraction let's see 6 minus 2 is 4 5 minus 4 is 1 7 minus 8 we cannot subtract a bigger number from a smaller number बिगर नंबर सहित सॉरी स्मॉलर नंबर सहित बिगर नंबर को आम कौन कर सब्ट्रैक्ट कर सो दिस इज व्हाट नाउ इनवैलिड ओके 3 माइनस 9 सो फर्स्ट इज बिगर नंबर सॉरी स्मॉलर नंबर सेकंड इज बिगर नंबर सो दिस इज व्हाट फॉर अस दिस सब्ट्रैक्शन इज इनवैलिड सो ऑल व्हेन टू नंबर्स आर सब्ट्रैक्टेड Always we are not getting the whole number. So this is are the whole numbers closed under subtraction? No. Okay. Next is division. Are the whole numbers closed under division? 8 divided by 4 how much? 2. 12 divided by 3 how much? 4. 5 divided by 7. So 5 is greater. Sorry, smaller and 7 is bigger. So what we are getting? 5 by 7. This fraction you are getting. Okay. 6 divided by 5. 6 is smaller and 5. 6 is bigger and small. 5 is smaller. But what we are getting? 6 by 5. Okay. So here what you are getting? A fraction. Not the whole number. So you are not getting always the whole number after division of whole numbers. The whole number could divide yourself. But you have to divide yourself. होल नंबर मिलूंगी दैट्स वाई द होल नंबर्स आर नॉट क्लोज्ड अंडर क्लोजर नॉट क्लोज्ड अंडर डिवीजन ओके सो फॉर सब्ट्रैक्शन एंड डिवीजन वी आर दीज प्रॉपर्टीज दीज ऑपरेशंस आर नॉट क्लोज्ड अंडर नॉट आर कमिंग अंडर क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी सो For closure property, we need only addition and multiplication. Okay. Next is division by zero. Okay. After dividing by zero, what we will get? So, division by a number means subtracting that number repeatedly. Okay. So, when we are dividing, we are subtracting that number repeatedly. So, let's see one example. Let's first find out a divided by 2. Okay. What we will do? We'll subtract two again from 8. Okay, we subtract 2 again and again from 8. So let's see how many times we will subtract the 2. Okay, so first we'll subtract 8 minus 2. What we are getting? 6. This is one time. 6 minus 2. What we are getting? 4. Second time we are second move this is 4 minus 2. How much? 2. Third time 2 minus 2. 0. How many time? 4 time. So when you are subtracting 4 time, 4 times, or when you are subtracting 4 times 2, then what you are getting? 0. So how much answer is? So we can write. So A divided by 2 equal to 4. 4. Like that you can find out 24 divided by 8. Okay. And 16 divided by 4. So like this, by subtracting again and again, you can find out the result of this division. Okay, so this is about the normal division property. Normal division. So let's find out when you will do the same subtraction. Okay, subtracting method in division. So let's try 2 divided by 0. So what we'll do? We'll subtract 0. Here subtract 0 again and again from 2. Okay. So 2 minus 0. How much? 2. 2 minus 0. How much? 2. 2 times 2 minus 0. How much? What you are getting? 2. That is 3 times 2 minus 0. How much? 2. 4 times 2 minus 0. How much? 2. 5 times. Like this. This will continue like this. Okay. Because how many times you will subtract 0 from 2, you will get always 2. तो सब बड़े 2 से तो कौन कर रहे हो? 0 को subtract कर चलो कर चलो. But always you are getting what? 2. So it is what? It is coming that it is never stopping. Okay. It will never stop. So what you will say? Will say that. So 2 divided by 0 is not defined. So anything means anything divided by 0 is not defined. So what you will write it? Division of a whole number by 0 is not defined. Okay. Any whole number. You can write as 116 divided by 0. What you will write? Not defined. So division of a whole number by 0 is not defined. Next, see commutative of addition and multiplication. So this is second property. This second property is what? Commutative property. Commutative property, or you can say that commutativity. Commutativity. Okay. So let's find out what is commutativity. 3 plus 2 is how much? 5. Okay. When you exchange the position of number, I'll keep 2 first and 3 in second position. So what you'll find? First position 2 and second position 3. Do the answer come different? Answer come different as you go. 3 plus 2, 5 as well. 2 plus 3 come different answer as well. Let's see. 2 plus 3 equal to also 5. Okay. So, let's see again one number. 5 plus 3 equal to how much? 8. Exchange the number. Now 5 comes to second position and 3 comes to first position. So 3 plus 5, it is also how much? 8. So when you are changing the position of number or exchanging the numbers place in a addition, then what it is happening? The sum is not changing. Sum kono change hoche. 3 plus 2 is also 5. 2 plus 3 is also 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. 3 plus 5 is also 8. Here you have exchanged the position of numbers. ओके और यू हैव चेंज द ऑर्डर तुम्हें ऑर्डर को चेंज कर चो पोजीशन को चेंज कर चो बट तुम्हारा सम इज कौन इक्वल सेम सो व्हेन द ऑर्डर ऑफ एडिशन इज चेंज्ड द सम ऑफ एनी पेयर ऑफ होल नंबर्स इज नॉट चेंज्ड ओके सो व्हेन यू आर चेंजिंग द ऑर्डर ऑफ एडिशन ऑर्डर चेंज कर सम ऑफ एनी पेयर ऑफ होल नंबर इज नॉट चेंज चेंज होने ओके सो यू कैन एड एनी टू होल नंबर्स इन एनी ऑर्डर एडिशन इज कम्यूटेटिव फॉर होल नंबर्स दिस इज कॉल्ड कम्यूटेटिविटी ऑफ होर एडिशन व्हाट इज कॉल्ड कम्यूटेटिविटी ओके सो कम्यूटेटिविटी फॉर एडिशन इज व्हाट व्हेन यू आर चेंजिंग द ऑर्डर ऑफ एनी मीन्स यू आर अरेंजिंग द होल नंबर्स इन एनी ऑर्डर यू द रिजल्ट इज नॉट चेंजिंग जब तक तुम 5 प्लस 3 कर चो कि 3 प्लस 5 कर चो कौन पाओ चो 8 सो दैट इज व्हाट कम्यूटेटिविटी फॉर एडिशन सो लेट्स सी अबाउट मल्टीप्लिकेशन 6 इनटू 8 6 8 जा 48 8 6 जा 48 ओके 5 4 जा 20 देन वी आर एक्सचेंजिंग द प्लेस 4 5 जा 20 लेट्स सी 3 6 जा 18 6 3 जा 18 5 7 जा 35 देन अगेन यू एक्सचेंज 7 5 जा 35 सो इन मल्टीप्लिकेशन आल्सो व्हेन यू आर एक्सचेंजिंग द ऑर्डर देन द रिजल्ट इज सेम 6 8 जा 8 इनटू 6 also the same result 5 into 4 what is the result the same result you are getting 4 into 5 also 3 into 6 equal to 6 into 3 5 into 7 equal to 7 into 5 so you can multiply two whole numbers in any order tam multiplication kar paribo any order 8 ko agar rakhi paribo 6 ko par rakhi paribo na 6 ko agar rakhi paribo 8 ko agar par paribo if you will keep 6 first and 8 second or 8 first and 6 second the result is same result is not changing that's why this is called multiplication is commutative for whole numbers so in commutative what we are getting addition and multiplication are commutative for whole numbers okay so this is about commutative property okay let's see verify what will verify we will verify either subtraction and division these are coming under commutative or not okay so subtraction is not commutative for whole numbers so let's see subtraction is coming or not 8 minus 6 equal to how much 2 okay so here we have exchanged the place changed the order so 6 is coming first and 8 is going to second 6 minus 8 means less number minus big number means small number minus big number is what invalid okay 4 minus 5 small number minus big number is how much invalid but we have exchanged the places exchange the order change the order 5 minus 4 equal to 1 like that you can find out for rest of the this so by seeing this what we can say subtraction is not commutative subtraction is not commutative subtraction commutative no in whole numbers let's see about division 6 divided by 3 equal to how much 2 but 3 divided by 6 is how much 3 by 6 so here we are changing the order okay so 6 is going to second position and 3 is coming to first position what we are getting we are getting a fraction so division is also not commutative for whole numbers like that 8 divided by 2 how much 4 when we are exchanging 2 is coming to first place and 8 is going to second place 2 divided by 8 equal to 2 by 8 like that we can find out for this Okay, so this is what showing that subtraction, both subtraction and division are not commutative for whole numbers. So let's see associativity of addition and multiplication. So this is the third property of whole numbers. What is that? Associativity. Okay, so associativity of addition and multiplication. So let's see. Okay, so we have taken three numbers, 2 + 3 + 4. So this 2 + 3 is in bracket. So according to Bodman's rule, what we are doing, which is in bracket, will do that operation first. Jota bracket bhitar thibo taku am first kariba. So 2 + 3 equal to how much? 5. Then we'll write 4. So 5 + 4 equal to 9. So here first two numbers are in bracket. Okay, next we'll see 2 + 3 + 4. The same three numbers are written in same order. Same order rakhai ji. 2 ko first, 3 ko second, 4 ko third. What? But what change here happened? Here change is there the bracket is coming under 3 and 4. So 3 and 4 numbers are inside bracket. Amaro bracket bhitar ko kya achi? 3 + 4. So first we'll do this one. So what you will write? The first number 2, then plus, then we'll add this one 3 + 4 equal to how much? 7. So look at here. What we are getting? 2 + 7 equal to 9. So look at here. In first addition, what we have done? We have added first two numbers which are in bracket. But in second one, what we have done? We have taken last two numbers in bracket and we have added this last two numbers which are in bracket. So are the sums changed? Are the results changed? No. Results are what? Same. So when we are, what we are doing? When we are putting the bracket, the first two numbers or last two numbers, the answer is the same. So answer is not changing. So this is about associativity of addition. Let's see another one. 5 + 7 + 3. 5 + 7 + 3. The same number written. So 5 + 7. First we have taken first two numbers. Second one we have taken second two numbers. So first we'll add 5 + 7 equal to 12 + 3. So 12 + 3 equal to how much? 15. So let's see this second one. 5 plus. So we'll write 5 plus. This last two numbers are in bracket. 7 + 3 equal to how much? 10. So what we are getting? 5 + 10 equal to 15. So answers are same. We are changing the bracket position, but answer is same. So this is associativity of addition for whole numbers. Like this, you can do the third one. So I am keeping this for you, and you can do by yourself this addition and this addition by associativity property. Okay. Let's see about multiplication. What it is written? Look at here. The same number 2, 3, 4. So these are in same order. Okay. What you are getting? First two numbers are in bracket, and here second two numbers are in bracket. So first two numbers, second two numbers are in bracket. So bracket's position is changed. Let's see. First we'll do which one is in bracket according to Bodman's rule. So according to your Bodman's rule, so first which is in bracket will do that operation. So 2 into 3 equal to how much? 6 into 4. So 6 × 4 = 24. Next see 2 × 3 × 4. So first we'll write 2 into, and 3 into 4 is in bracket. So 3 × 4 = 12. So 2 × 12 = how much? 24. So look, both are same. So we are getting same product. We have changed the bracket position, but still we are getting the same product. Let's again look at the second one. 3 × 5 × 4. So write down. 3 × 5 = 15. × 4, 15 × 4 = 60. Like that. Here we will write. First we will write 3 × 5 = 20. So 3 × 20 = 60. So both are equal. So by looking this, we can say that when we are changing the position of bracket in any 3 or 4 whole number, we are getting the whole number and the same whole number. Okay, the answer is not changing. So this is what associative property for multiplication of whole number. So rest you can do by yourself. Next, is there an associative property for division or subtraction? Let's see. Here I have given two examples. Let's see. Okay, associative property. So here first one is in bracket, second one is in bracket. Okay, so 16 − 4 = 12. Then 12 − 2, how much you are getting? 10. Next, 16 you will write 16 − 4 − 2, how much? 2. Okay, so 16 − 2 = 40. So these two are different. Okay, look at here, these two are different. That's why that subtraction is not coming under your associative property. Okay, so let's see the division. 16 / 4 / 2. So 16 / 4 = 4 × 4 = 16 / 2. How much you are getting? 2. 4 / 2 = 2. Next, 16 / 4 / 2 = how much? 2. So 16 / 2 = how much? 8. So look at here, when we have done the associative property or changed the position of bracket, then what it has happened? The result is not same. The result is different in what? Division. That's why both subtraction and division are not coming under associative property. So let's see. Your fourth one is, which is fourth property is distributivity. Okay, distributivity of multiplication over addition. So what is that? Distributivity of multiplication over addition. So distributivity. So this term has come from the word that is distribute. Okay, distribute. Distribute means when somebody is telling, your mother is telling, distribute the chocolates among your brothers and sister. Okay, means tame tama brother or sister bhitare kon kare banti kunti ki chocolate khao bole kahanti banti va jo houchi, that is distribute. So ame kon karchu here, distributivity of multiplication over addition. So ame kon karchu multiplication ku distribute karchu over addition saitha. Okay, so let's see. 6 × 8. Okay, so what we have written? 6 × 5 + 3. So 8 ko ame kon likhi pariba? 5 + 3. So we are distributing multiplication over addition. So let's see how we can do. We can multiply 6 × 5. Okay, like this. So first multiplication, then you put the addition sign put kar, then we can distribute with 3 also. First we have distribute the multiplication of with 5. First ame 5 sahito distribute khole, then second ame kon kariba? 3 sahito distribute kariba. So 6 × 5, then second one is 6 × 3. Okay, so 6 × 5 = how much? 30. 6 × 3 equal to how much? 6 × 3 = 18. So how much you are getting? 30 + 18 equal to 48. So answer is what? When you are distributing, you are getting this type of answer. So here you can distribute multiplication over addition. We'll see the second one. 4 × 5 + 8. So first you will distribute. कहाँ को distribute करियो? First number से तो. Always distribute with first number. Then you will distribute the multiplication with the second number. So first you will do 4 × 5. Keep it in bracket. Then don't forget this plus sign. Put plus sign. Then distribute 8. 4 × 8. Okay. So what you are getting? 4 × 5 = 20, 4 × 8 = 32. What you are getting? The answer is 20 + 32 equal to 52. Like that you can distribute the what? You can distribute these things. Okay. You can distribute like this. Okay. So this is known as distributivity of multiplication over addition. So let's see. You are given 425 × 136. So let's see, 425 × 136, 425. How we are distributing? So first we are, when we are multiplying, what we are doing? We are multiplying first one's number with first we are multiplying 425 × 6. Okay, so we are multiplying 425 × 6 1. Like that we are getting what? 6 × 5 = 30, 6 × 2 = 12 + 3 = 15, 6 × 4 = 24 + 1 = 25. Like that first we are multiplying 6 ones into by 425. Next what we are doing? We will multiply 3 ones with 425. So 425, this is 6 ones, then 3 tens means 30. We are multiplying 3 tens means 30. So what we are getting? 0, 5, 7, 2, 1. Like this. Next, what we will do? We will multiply 425 by 1 is what? 100. So what you will get? 5, 2, 4. So let's find out the answer. What you are getting? 0, 0, 8, 7, 5. So this is the answer we are getting when we are multiplying. So you can write it as 425 into 6, 6, 1 is what? 6, 3, 1 is 3 tens means what? 30, 100 means what? 100. You can write this like this. Okay. So instead of when you have got 425 × 136. Okay, this is the big number. You have to multiply like this. So how you can multiply? You break this number into like this. So 425 × 100 + 30 + 6. Like that you can break. Next, according to distributivity, first you multiply with first number, then multiply it second number, then multiply with third number. Like this you can multiply. So how you can write? You can write it as 425 × 100. Okay. Plus 4 plus, don't forget to write after this, 425 × 30. Okay. Next, plus 425 × 6. Okay. So like that you can easily find out 4, 2, 5, 0. You can easily multiply this. Instead of multiplying the whole number, you can easily multiply this. Then plus 1, 2, 7, 5, 0. Okay, when you're multiplying 425 into 30, then plus when you're multiplying 425 into 66, what you are getting? 2550. So answer is what? The same answer you are getting what you have got here. 57800. So this is about distributivity of multiplication over addition. Okay, so you have to remember that you are multiply with first number, then keep addition, keep the plus sign, then multiply with second number, then again keep the plus sign, then multiply with last number. Okay, so like that you can do the distribution of multiplication over addition. Next is identity. Last one is what? That fifth one is identity for addition and multiplication. So identity is what? Identity is coming from 1. Okay. Identity is 1 or your coming from 1. So that is for addition and multiplication. So look at here. Okay. So identity you can as tell as same. Okay. When you add 0 to any whole number, jatrale 0 ko any whole, kon se bhi whole number se to add karcho. What you are getting same whole number. So let's see, 7 plus 0 equal to how much? 7. 0 plus 15 equal to how much? 15. 125 plus 0 equal to how much? 125. 9730 plus 0 equal to how much? 9730. Like that you can rest find out. So, when you are adding 0 to any whole number, you are getting the same whole number. That's why 0 is an identity for addition of whole numbers. Or you can say additive identity for whole numbers. So, a number remains unchanged when added to 0. Jatale 0 se ta kono se bhi number add karcho, what you are getting? That you are getting the same number tame paucho. That's why 0 is identity for addition of whole numbers. Okay. So, let's see. If you are multiplying 0 with whole number, are you getting the same whole number? So, let's see. Find 5 into 0 is how much? 0. 0 into 15 is how much? 0. 125 into 0 is how much? 0. 0 into 7 equal to 0. So any number when multiplied by 0 becomes 0. So this is not multiplicative identity. 0 is not identity for multiplication. Multiplication by identity no. So what is the identity? So what you multiply so that what number you can multiply so that you can get the same whole number? When you multiply 1 to any whole number, 1 to any whole number, then you get the same whole number. Tame 1 se to jetal multiply karcho kono se whole number ko tale kon paucho sei same whole number. Let's see. 7 into 1, 7. 1 into 15, 15. 125 into 1, 125. So when you are multiplying 1 with any whole number, you are getting the same whole number. So what you will say? 1 is called the identity for multiplication. So multiplication for identity ki 1, but addition by identity ki 0. So for addition, identity is 0. So when you are adding 0 to any whole number, you are getting the same whole number. Like that, for multiplication, identity is 1. So, when you are multiplying 1 with any whole number, you are getting the same whole number. So, multiplicative identity for whole number is 1. A number remains unchanged when multiplied to 1. So, this is about today's class. We have studied about all the properties of whole numbers. I hope you have understood. Okay. Thank you.